Last night saw another cracking Dancing on Ice.
Your upper line and carriage of your body was exquisite tonight, so well done.
It was strong and passionate. I loved that.
It happened perfectly tonight, and you absolutely nailed every move.
It was a little bit like watching two people play Twister.
And our Dancing on Ice woman in the know is Hayley Tamaden. Hello, welcome.
Good morning.
Good morning. What a night it was. Very exciting. I think the whole two teams vibe of the whole night just gave the show that sort of little kick, didn't it?
I think it's one of my favourite shows so far, actually, because not only was the whole show quite tense, backstage it was so energetic as well. Everybody was so excited about the two group numbers. But, you know, did it have an effect on their solo performances? I think maybe it did a little bit.
Who?
I think that Sam might have spent a lot of time working on the group number, which is great because he really wanted to do well for his team, obviously knowing that the team would get double the points. But I don't know whether he might have jeopardised his own skate for that putting in that effort with his group number.
Well, it's interesting because he did slip down the leaderboard a little bit. The challenges were fascinating because I wonder whether... controversially.
What are you going to say?
I'm going to say that everyone got caught up in the atmosphere of Team Laura's skate. Sorry, guys. But that they didn't notice the skating. Because I thought that Sam's team were the better skaters.
They
went first, so the atmosphere hasn't hyped itself up quite so much. But I thought that their routine was much more cohesive.
It was. They had a lot more content in their routine. And you have to look at somebody like Chloe, who was then in that routine with two other female professionals who are amazing, and she didn't stand out. Their team was solid, it was great, their skating was fantastic. Whether it had, the whole Team Laura thing, they came out, they had more energy maybe than these guys.
But I just thought as a routine, it looked better choreographed. The routine itself was better choreographed. No, I'm not saying that this is terrific. The guys are brilliant, but that Sam edged ahead.
They just did different things, didn't they?
They did.
I think. Like hers, Team Laura's was just exciting and you wanted to be part of it, whereas Team Sam.
Get that camera out of the way.
You wanted to watch it and be entertained by it.
They
were different. They were good in their own ways. I think it's quite tough.
Yeah. I watched the dress rehearsal and straight away my favourite team was Laura's.
Really? Was it?
Straight away I said, I prefer Laura's
team. I think
you
find yourself so drawn to watching Laura as well, though.
Yeah,
because she just gives such a great performance. Her facial expressions, the way she is, she's so good. So you tend to literally watch Laura, actually.
I mean, last night, Laura just gave the performance of her life.
28.5. 9.5s across the board.
Yeah, the highest mark so far. She was absolutely amazing. I mean, what she did last night as well, not only can you see the energy in her face, she put so many lifts, this trick you're seeing now, that's so hard to do. And you never look at her and think she'll falter, ever. She always looks great, always looks stable on her feet.
And that helicopter lift, I can't believe that he'd never done that before.
I know, and only decided to tell her on Friday.
I know!
Yeah, and nearly let go, but thought better of it.
Yeah, I know, see, so calm when he said to you, well, I nearly let go, but, you know, she's standing there going, oh, you never told me that.
So let's talk about Denise and and Tim standing.
Gosh, this was the best bit of TV I have seen in ages. She was absolutely had no idea.
Let's have a look.
It was a little bit like watching two people play Twister. It was like Matt did a position, then he assisted you into another position. There was no flow for me, not enough of a flow. So what I think needs to happen.
Listen, she's 52 and she's got four jobs.
Oh my God, you're great.
How many jobs have you got?
Transvestite off of Benidorm and run on there.
good on Tim for sticking up for the woman in his life.
I mean,
there is no question that if you maybe, and we don't know, you know, had a couple of glasses of wine in the bar beforehand, that does linger on your breath a little bit, and that you know, Jason is not going to let you get away with it, especially if you take him by surprise and you're right in his face.
I know.
Jason has commented on Twitter saying he stands by what he said.
Jason said a lot of outrageous things on Twitter.
He did.
Last night.
It was all fun and games, but he stands by what he said, and he's a truthful man.
So when Phil and I have just said, you know, we sort of support him on his running out of the audience, can we just say, stop there, though? Yeah. Nobody else has the same idea. Please. Well,
you imagine every week.
No, thankfully,
security recognised that it was Tim, otherwise anyone else would have been wrestled to the floor before they got
what
there.
What was I made a joke yesterday? Behind every loose woman is a man on the loose.
Very good.
I can do jokes.
I like that one. It's a shame that she had to leave.
Yes, it is.
But
a shame.
I do think the public made a right choice last night. You know, you never know with the scores when they tip them upside down. Were the public going to save their favourite person or were they going to save the best skaters? And everybody backstage was so worried that it could have been a Chloe and Sam skate-off last night.
Well, it was a shame to lose Denise.
It really was.
Such good fun.
Yeah.
I think she'll be on with the Loose Ladies later on today.
She is. And
quite,
you know,
rightly, that's where she's giving her exclusive chat.
We've not seen the end of her. She's coming on tour with me. Yeah. So, in actual fact, she's probably only got a week off before she starts training again for the tour, so that's great for her because she was, you know,
it was timed quite right, wasn't it? She was ready.
Yeah,
she looked relieved.
She said, "I need a holiday."
Yeah,
she's got a week. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Right, now it's your first chance to enter.